So what's going on, guys? It's JM, it's Speakboxing. Make sure you guys subscribe to the channel before you click on 20 of my videos. Also comment below in the comment section if you guys have any opinions on what I'm saying in any of my videos. Like always, it is appreciated if you guys could drop me a quick sub or two on my channel. So Kell Brook has came out since his 11th round stoppage loss to Devastating the Spence Jr. last Saturday night, in which he lost his IBF welterweight title. Kell Brook quitting the 11th round against Devastating the Spence after picking up an injury to his eye in which he couldn't continue. And it later came out that Kell Brook had fractured his eye socket. Not the same eye socket he fractured against Golovkin, but the other one, which is very rare. You don't see a fighter break his eye bone, well, his orbital bone, twice in two consecutive fights. And it's even stranger that it's two different eye sockets. But Kell Brook has gone on to say that Golovkin is a much more devastating puncher than Devastating the Spence Jr. But that's no surprise, is it? Because Golovkin is a middleweight. He's a naturally bigger guy, and the thing with Golovkin, he has got very heavy hands, and it's the way he throws the shots as well. Like Golovkin sets up the big shots fantastically. He's got excellent balance, so when he throws the shots, they're very accurate, they're very precise, and he kind of knows where to hit you. Golovkin, like, he hits you square in the temple, or he hits you square in the sweet spot in the body. And it's not really surprising that Golovkin is a much more devastating puncher than Devastating the Spence, because Devastating the Spence isn't a massive puncher. He isn't a knockout artist, like a one punch knockout artist. I mean, like, he does stop guys in fights, Devastating the Spence, but it's due to an accumulation of punches. He kind of like bludgeons his opponents to the ground, Devastating the Spence. That's the kind of way he fights. He gets on the inside and just bludgeons his opponents into submission. But don't get me wrong, he isn't not a big puncher, Devastating the Spence, but he isn't a one punch knockout artist like a Gennady Golovkin, and he isn't as devastating as a Golovkin. Like, we seen when Gennady Golovkin knocked Matthew Macklin out a few years ago, like, that was just a devastating body punch. So that's what I mean when Gennady Golovkin just knows where to hit you in the right spots. Like, even when he broke Kell Brook's eye, that was just like, it didn't even look like a massive shot when he hit Kell Brook. When it broke his eye socket, it just looked like a grazing shot, but it completely shattered Kell Brook's eye socket. Whereas Devastating the Spence, it was more of an accumulation of punches that really damaged the eye of Kell Brook. So yeah, Devastating the Spence is saying that the opponent he wants next is out of these three guys, Danny Garcia, Lamont Peterson, or Keith Thurman. And I think we're in the stage now in the welterweight division where all the top fighters should be fighting each other. Like, no one should be going backwards now. I think everyone should be fighting each other. Thurman, Spence, or Spence, Garcia, or Porter, Spence, or Garcia, Thurman again, or Spence, Porter. Like, there should just be a round robin now of these top welterweights. And Kell Brook, I don't know if Kell Brook's going to come back down to 147. I don't think it's good for Kell Brook's health to come back down to 147. I think he might have to try his hand at like middleweight, see how he gets on there. But there are some dangerous fighters at 154 pounds. There are guys like Erislandy Lara and Jamel Charlo and Demetrius Andrade, which are very hard fights for Kell Brook. But he wants to continue his career, and he wants to have a couple more fights, he's saying. He says he's still got stuff left in him, and he still wants to get on with his career. He's just got to wait for the injury to heal. He's got to wait for the swelling to go down in his eye, and then he's going to have an operation. Apparently, this fracture is a larger fracture than the one against Gennady Golovkin, but apparently this makes the surgery easier. I don't know how it all works, but yeah, this is what Kell Brook is saying. So comment below in the comment section, what do you think of Kell Brook's comments here about Devastating the Spence? What do you think Kell Brook should do next? And who do you think Devastating the Spence should fight next? Who do you think the top fighters should be facing in the welterweight division? Do you think they should all be facing each other? Or is there any other guys you know who would be good fights for Devastating the Spence? Maybe Terence Crawford come up to 147 pounds and get himself in the mix. Like, there are some very good fights right now in the welterweight division. Oh, and Manny Pacquiao as well. Forgot all about Pacquiao. He can be in the mix as well still, if he's still got a couple of fights left in him. So yeah, comment below in the comment section. It's JM, it's Speakboxing. Got them extra crispy brownies for your baby. Extra crispy for your baby.